Yesterday, Rory asked me how I got to know Ben to begin with. So let me repeat what I told him. I went to Cornell in 1968 to study sociology and South Asian studies. And Ben was my supervisor in the field of South Asian studies. When I went to see him for the first time in his office, he just finished his PhD in 1967, a year ahead of my arrival in Cornell. And he was just appointed as the assistant professor at the Department of Government at Cornell. And being the youngest and newest faculty member, when I went to see him, he was properly dressed, tie and jacket. But there was one thing which was not proper in his attire. When he turned around to pick up something at his back, his shirt tail was sticking out from his behind, the below the jacket. And I thought, I can get along with this guy nicely. And we got along very nicely for all these years. I went to Indonesia for fieldwork in West Sumatra in 1972 and came back to Cornell in 1974. The Ben I knew in 1968 and Ben I got to know in 1974 were different in his dress. In 1968, as I mentioned, he was dressed in tie and jacket. In 1974, he was all in blue jeans. And his favorite was denim overall. Can you imagine Ben in denim overall? And I think he must have been in some kind of midlife crisis at that time. So he went on wearing denim all year round. And then, as you know, Pablo Picasso went through blue period, rose period, cubism. So I think Ben went through the period of tie and jacket, and the period of jeans, and last period, guess what kind of period? He was in the period of t-shirt, short pants, and sandals. With a wicked and mischievous smile. Oh, that's the way I remember them. Canis mentioned the autobiography, which I understand is supposed to come out next February from Dasso. And it was originally published in Japanese in 2009. And that was a book which Ben never wanted to write. But he was put in the position to write it by strong urging from one female Japanese editor and me. And as Rory mentioned, Ben always had this soft spot for young people. So the sales pitch, Miss Endo, this female editor, sort of told to Ben was, please write this book for the young Japanese scholars and graduate students who want to be scholars. And he said, okay, if that's the case, I have many good Japanese friends, maybe this is one way of returning or saying thank you to his to their friendship. The book, the title of the book is called Out of the Coconut Half Shell. This is alluding to the Indonesian proverb, kata dibawa tempurun. So we live in the self-imposed boundaries, like disciplines, academic disciplines, personal feeling of nationalism, or maybe gender. And to be creative, intellectual, you have to get out of the boundaries. And the title of the English book, which is very similar but not exactly the same as the Japanese version, is Life Beyond Boundaries, so same meaning as the Japanese title. And I just want to quote the last paragraph he put for the Japanese edition. I think probably more similar paragraph must be put at the end of the English edition. I read. For a very long time, this is a message to the young people. For a very long time, different forms of socialism, anarchist, Leninist, new leftist, social democrat, provided a global framework in which progressive, emancipationist nationalism could flourish. Since the fall of communism in its Stalinist, Maoist forms, there has been a global vacuum, partially filled by feminism, environmentalism, neo-anarchism, and various forms, various other isms, fighting in different and not always cooperative ways against the barrenness of neoliberalism and Machiavellian human rights interventionalism. But a lot of work over a long period of time will be needed to fill the vacuum. This is the task to which young scholars can make vital contributions. Slogan, frogs of the world, unite. You have nothing to lose but your coconuts. That's his concluding paragraph of the biography. Now, I wrote a very long afterword to the Japanese edition, and I ended the afterword with waka. This is a longer version of a haiku I composed for this occasion. And I read first in Japanese, which is Greek to all of you, but I will nevertheless read it. And then English translation. Atogaki o shitatame umashi sake o nomi, sake o hoshi, tomoto no tabi ni totemu utsu. English translation is, just finish the afterword. Enjoy a sweet taste of sake and put a comma to the wonderful intellectual journey I shared with my dear friend, thinking that there's still many years to come to continue the journey, but reluctantly I have to put the period to the journey. Thank you.